Now, Kosha, let's turn to the US. Former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has told what has surely got to be a joke. Have a look.
Top of his game. Such a consequential president of the United States, a Mount Rushmore kind of president of the United States.
Are
want
you
to
really
know what comes next?
That he belongs up there on Mount Rushmore. Lincoln and Joe Biden.
But you got Teddy Roosevelt up there, and he's wonderful. I don't say take him down, but you can add Biden.
I mean, Nancy Pelosi helped bring Joe Biden down. Now she says he was at the top of his game, should be chipped into rock alongside George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Abraham Lincoln, Teddy Roosevelt, when he's never been more confused. Kosha, maybe she's lost her marbles as well.
You know, I would say that Nancy Pelosi is a master politician and a master tactician, and if she's saying anything, even now, she has purpose behind it. I think what we're seeing is sort of the sandwich, where she was nice about him and was backing him in the beginning. After that disastrous debate, she was widely reported as being one of the key players in the mutiny that the Democrats ran against their own nominee and the switcheroo that they pulled off. And now she's closing the sandwich with some nice words and very effusive, euphemistic words out there about him. I don't think it'll ever happen, but I think it's meant to say, you know what, we did what we had to do. We replaced him. The polls are tightening as a result of that, and now we can give him something really nice, whether it's Mount Rushmore or something less. That's all part of, I think, the strategy.
And meanwhile, Kamala Harris and Donald Trump, according to reports, are neck and neck. This is the latest CBS YouGov poll. The vice president is now, according to the poll, it's one poll, but she's apparently got a one-point lead nationally. This is erasing the five-point lead that Trump had over Biden. Look, the polls got it wrong before, plenty of times before, but it does appear that Kamala Harris is catching up and making ground on Donald Trump, and we're only a few months out now from the election.
I think so. You know, as you mentioned, polls have not covered themselves in glory in recent years around the world, but I think what we are seeing is America is a very divided country. The last several elections have been won and lost on razor-thin margins, and we're seeing a restoration back to that dynamic. And basically what was happening when Biden was in the ticket after that debate is there was a big chunk of Democrats that just couldn't do it because it was so disastrous, his cognitive decline. Those people are coming back home, and that's sort of evening out the playing field between the two of them, regardless of the flaws or the peculiarities of the particular candidacy in Kamala. This is going to continue to be a razor-thin election, and it's really interesting because it's never happened in modern times where they've done this and basically installed somebody who's never had a single vote from the Democrat voters and the Democrat base, and yet here she is, you know, very, very close to possibly taking the top job.
And is untested in debates and still appears to be untested in media interviews. But you'd have to think, if Donald Trump doesn't win in November, I mean, this would have to be the last time he would run, because this is his third time standing for president. I mean, he has enormous support in the Republican Party, but surely if he loses two elections in a row, he couldn't go again. And his age as well.
Yeah, it would appear so. I mean, with Trump, you never know. But yes, he's almost 80 years old. At that point, he would be 84. I think that's a fair conclusion. And many would say his picking of J.D. Vance maybe is sort of a nod to that, that whether he wins or loses, he sort of wanted to pave the way for somebody that can carry the mantle of Trumpism, populism, you know, all the policies that he stood for in somebody who's quite young and has a long future ahead of him in Republican politics.
Yeah, exactly. Only 39 years old, I think, turns 40 perhaps this month, J.D. Vance. All right, Kosha Gada, thank you very much for your time.